The issue of women international, I know, is a critical focus here at Glass Ceiling, and rightly so. If we look at what's happened in America over the last 50 years, my mother's generation and my grandmother's generation, of women entering the workforce in large numbers, first to help defeat fascism with Rosie the Riveter, and then to help defeat the discrimination of the Mad Men era, that's been a critical part of growth in American society, an opportunity for not only 50% of the American population, but for all that that's meant in terms of economic innovation and lifting up whole families and communities. That's been absolutely critical to the success of America over the last 50 years. And America, in many respects, well, not the leading country, some of the European countries were even more out front in advancing women. America has been one of the leading countries. And as that trend extends all across the world, you see it now in Asia, you see it now in Latin America, you see it in Africa, and you see it even in the Middle East, which traditionally has been one of the most discriminatory areas for women. I travel, both when I was at the State Department and in my consulting business now, to the Gulf a lot. And some of the greatest minds in the Gulf, some of the greatest innovations, come from the women, who have to prove so much, who've been discriminated against in so many ways. And those are societies that, while they're deeply repressive, have tremendous hope. And that hope, frankly, comes largely from the women. And if it can happen in Saudi Arabia or Qatar, it can happen anywhere. And it's, I think, one of the most important forces in lifting up societies that have been left behind and that want to move on, not just in exports or natural resources that are important, but in the higher end industries and creativity, in the artistic industries, where the returns are ever more greater.